of you are confused what's left, right? I think everyone's had a good lunch. Stretch out your left hand, let the index finger touch the thumb. All right, and place it next to your chin. Now ask yourself, is that your chin or your cheek? The reason you did this is because you saw me do it. Moral of the story, actions speak louder than words. And if you need to 5x your business, you need to take massive action. How many of you here want to 5x your business? Can I have a show of hands, please? Some people are raising both their hands. Looks like they want 10x growth. All right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to share with you three key insights using which you can scale your business. Are you ready? Come on, I need a resounding yes. Are you ready? Yes. All right, let's get started. Can we have the slides, please? Stop being a mom. A typical mother is someone who does everything. She'll prepare food for the child, she'll put you to sleep, she'll send you to school, she will play with you, she will teach you, she will cry for you. The list is just endless. Surprisingly, a lot of business owners are like moms. They will do marketing, they will do sales, they will do the hiring, they will do the accounting, they will do R&D. They will do pretty much everything in the business. If you really want to scale up, you should stop being a mom. If not the mom, who should you be? Give me ideas. Who should you be if not the mom? Dad? No, not a good idea. He has no idea what's happening in the house. So not the dad. You need to be the neighbor. Because the neighbor knows everything that's happening in the house, what the mom is doing, what the dad is doing, what the kids are doing, and the neighbor always has advice on how it can be done better. So your role as the business owner is to just build a team and make sure that the team is performing. As they say, you build people and people will build your company. The thin line of difference between working on your business and in it. Thin line of difference, working on your business and in it. Ask yourselves, are you really working on your business? That's point number one, stop being a mom. The second point is 80-20. How many of you are aware of the classic Pareto's principle 80-20? It's about 20% of the audience. Again, goes on to prove the principle. This is applicable in all aspects of life. For instance, 80% of the world's wealth is owned by 20% of the people. Yes or no? Yes? 80% of what comes in the exam is from 20% of the syllabus that we haven't studied. Yes or no? 80% of the problems we face in life are caused by 20% of the people. These people are also called relatives. Yes or no? I was just kidding. The list is just endless. How do you apply this to business is 80% of your revenue is actually coming from only 20% of your clients. Think about it. If you were to do the math, 80% of your revenue is actually coming only from 20% of your clientele. And that's true with respect to any business irrespective of the industry. And the remaining 80% of the clients, well, your team is actually spending 80% of their time servicing these clients who shouldn't be clients in the first place. What you need to do is go back and create what I call as the ICP, an ideal customer profile. Those customers who land up in the 80% revenue bracket. Just because a customer is paying you does not mean he should be your customer. You've got to go and research on your ICP, which adds up to your chunk of revenue. Moving to my third point, which is automate. What should you automate? Give me some answers. What should you automate? What processes? Yeah. Automate the business itself? What do you automate? Sales process? Can you get more specific about the sales process? Lead generation, absolutely. You need to automate your lead generation and your lead closure processes. If you can't build an automated sales pipeline, there's no way you can go 5x. Let's understand this. It's almost 3 o'clock here. How many of you have generated leads today for your business? Look around you, look around you. How many of you have generated some leads, not from talking to each other, in general? Only two hands, four, five. The reason maybe you're personally involved here or your sales team is out there trying to get leads. Well, trying is not a great business strategy. You've got to build a system which is churning out, say, 10 leads a day. And you have another team, which I call the closing team, which closes a good four or five of them. So even if you're sitting here attending this wonderful conference here in Hyderabad, you're still making money end of the day. I know it's easier said than done to automate it, but you've got to figure it out. It could be social media, it could be AI, it could be bots, it could be WhatsApp marketing. You need to figure out a way to automate your lead generation and lead closure processes. Am I making sense? Yes or no? Right? Because this is something really crucial. You cannot scale what you cannot automate. Think about it. You cannot scale what you cannot automate. So if all of your energy is going just to chase leads, where am I going to get my next lead from? 5x is very far. All right. Here's what I want you to do. Find out the number of brown objects in this room. I'll give you 15 seconds. The number of brown objects in this room. Quick, your time starts now. I have a special award for you. All the brown objects in this room. Quick. Keep counting, keep counting. Five, four, three, two, one. How many red objects you found? How many red objects did you find? I'm sure you found zero red objects while you were looking for the brown objects. Why? That is because you are wearing a brown filter. Yes or no? Using which you will only see brown objects during those 15 seconds that I gave you. My question is, are you wearing a 5X filter? Do you really see 5X happening with your business? Do you really believe that it's possible in the first place? You know, I meet a lot of entrepreneurs, the filter that they wear is a break-even filter. Hey, I just want to break even. A lot of SMEs, they're only looking to recover salaries of their staff and make marginal profits at best. The question I want to ask you is, which filter are you wearing? Because a very narrow mindset is like a flat tire. You need to fix it before you move forward. All right, so I'll summarize the 3 points for you. The first point is stop. Stop, mom. No, don't stop, mom. Stop being a mom. Very important. Delegate. Point number two. The 80-20 principle, 80% of your revenue is actually coming from only 20% of your clientele. So go back and research on the ICP. Point number three. Automate your lead generation and your lead closure processes. All right, I'm going to end this talk with a quote which resonates with me very deeply. You can't go back and start a new beginning, but you can start now and make a new ending. Thank you so much. I wish you all a 5X growth. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you, Anmol. Thank you, Anmol. That was awesome. Thank you. That was power-packed, just what we needed. Anmol, hold on. I'm going to not leave you that easily.
You're not going
because
to
you
dance.
Said 5X business. Now there's a lot of questions out there. I'm sure people are going to ask you. Any questions?
You're speaking about automation. See, automation is something which almost everyone knows that, yes, we need to automate.
Right.
The first thing when we speak about automation, it comes is tech.
Okay. Right.
But what exactly you mean by automate? How can I automate? Because I know that, okay, there are certain things which I need to generate into my business on its own, ongoing, without my involvement.
Right.
But how can I actually deep dive into it to figure out what are the elements which...
Yes, what do you do?
I'm into wealth management, insurance and wealth management.
Perfect. How do you get clients?
Through digital marketing.
How many leads are you generating?
Almost currently 5 to 6 per day.
Okay. Do you have a sales team?
Yes, I have.
What is the number right now?
Four.
What's the closure rate?
It's 80%.
It's 80%. So is he doing well in his business right now?
Yes,
that's fairly good. An 80% close rate is simply amazing. Give him a round of applause. Yeah. And by the way, that's a good form of marketing. Now everyone knows he is a financial expert, so people can actually go up to him. So when I say automate, it's something exactly what you're doing right now. You have a system in place which is generating leads. You have people who are closing it for you. So even while we are talking right now, your team might be on a call. right? So you've automated it to a certain extent. Normally, the problem is with conversions. That's what I see. How do you really, because there's so many wealth advisors, financial planners out there in the market, how do you differentiate yourself? Right, so the automation is with respect to, are you spending enough on your people right there, educating them, investing in their growth so that they can convert more? Right? I hope I answered that question. So you actually built an automated sales lead generation and a closure process. But trust me, there are a lot of business owners who miss on that part.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah, thank you.
Yep.
I think to add to that, really, automation is really needed where there is a lot of people intensive processes.
Right.
That is where automation happens. You see a lot of this AI and machine language and all that going on. Wherever there is people, see, for example, there's an insurance company which has done a heavy amount of automation recently. And one of the areas that they have done automation is to find out, using machine language, whether the person who is buying a policy is likely to claim it back. You see, now as a human, we may tend to make a mistake in this judgment, because as he said, there are filters and we have our own conditioning way of judging people while issuing policies. But a machine, a language which has got some data which is collected over the last 20 years, 30 years, that is one of the ways in which automation happens. Yeah.
True.
Any other question? Okay. Now I'm going to call one more Mr. Garg, Mr. Gopal Garg, on stage to give a memento to Anmol. A round of applause for Anmol.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.